Okay, good afternoon children. In today's class, we are going to discuss about the factors that determine climate. So in that, the first one factor is the distance from the equator. So what is the meaning of equator? Equator means it is an imaginary line. Equator, it is an imaginary line on a globe which divides the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere, and it has the degree about 0 degree. It has a degree about 0 degree. So the first one factor is the distance from the equator. The sun has a major influence on the climate of a place. So sun is a major influence on the climate. The area along the equator gets direct heat from the vertical rays of the sun and is thus hotter than the other latitudes. The area, it is a sun. So the area along with the equator. The area along with the equator gets direct sun rays. The area along with the equator gets direct sun rays. Because of that, that areas are hotter than the other latitudes. As we move away from the equator, rays of the sun become slanty. This makes the climate less hot. As we move away from the equator, the sun rays becomes slanty. The sun rays becomes crosses. Because of that, these areas are less hot. Because these areas are in these areas, sun rays becomes slanty or sun rays becomes crosses. Because of that, these areas are or the areas which are away from the equator are less hot. And the next one point is a height above sea level. The next point is or next factor is height above sea level. So the altitude of a place also affect the climate. Altitude of a place also affect the climate. So next one factor is the height above sea level. The height of a place above the sea level is called the altitude of that place. The height of a place above the sea level is called the altitude of that place. The higher we go, the cooler it gets. The higher we go, the cooler it gets. The mountains, the places are, how much they are high now, that receives that much of cold. For example, mountains. Mountains are very high. Because of that, in these areas we can see very cold climate. For example, another example is the Himalayan ranges. Himalayan ranges are very high. Himalayan ranges are very high. Because of that reason, they get some snow. Because of that reason, they get some snow or For example, mountains and the Himalayan ranges. The height of a place above the sea level is called the altitude of that place. The higher we go, the cooler it gets. Places located at higher altitudes are cooler than places located at lower altitudes. The places which are at higher altitudes are cooler than the places which are located at the lower altitudes. For example, Bengaluru and Chennai. So, Bengaluru and Chennai are almost on the same latitude, but Bengaluru is much cooler than Chennai. So, Bengaluru and Chennai both are almost at the same latitude, but Bengaluru is much cooler than Chennai. Why? Because it is about 3,100 feet above the sea level. Bengaluru and Chennai both are located at the same latitude, but Bengaluru is cooler than the Chennai because Bengaluru is about 3,100 feet above from the sea level, while Chennai is located almost at the sea level. Bengaluru's height is about 3,100 feet above from the sea level, and Chennai is located almost at the sea level. Because of that, in Bengaluru we can see cold climate, and in Chennai we can see very hot climate. And the next one factor is distance from the sea. Distance from the sea. Distance from the sea. The third one point is the distance from the sea. Places closer to the sea are neither very hot nor very cold. Places which are very near or which are very close to the sea, that places are not that much of heat or not that much of cold. Whereas places far away from the sea have extreme climates. The places which are very close to the sea, the places are not that much of hot or not that much of cold. But the places which are away from the sea, in that places we can see very hot climates or very extreme climates. Delhi is very cold in the winters and very hot in the summers. Delhi is very cold in the winters and very hot in the summers because it is far away from any sea coast. Because Delhi is far away from the sea. Because of that, in winters Delhi is Delhi has very cold climate, and in summers Delhi has very hot climate because Delhi is far away from the sea coast. In summers, the breeze from the sea cools the hot air on the land. What is the meaning of breeze? Breeze means wind. Sea breeze is warm because water cools down slowly. sea breeze or sea wind is a warm because the water of a sea takes time. Sea breeze is a warm because the water pulls down slowly. As we know that water takes time to get cool. Because of that reason, sea breeze is a warm. That is why Mumbai, which is near the sea, experiences a moderate temperature throughout the year. In Mumbai, we can see very hot climate because of, moderate temperature. Moderate means not that much of a cold or not that much of a hot. The places which are near or the places which are closer to the sea, that places are not very hot and not very cold. So Mumbai, which is near the sea, experiences a moderate temperature throughout the year because Mumbai is very close to the sea. Because of that reason, in Mumbai we can see moderate temperature. And the next one is the direction of the winds. Direction of the winds. So the fourth one factor is the direction of the winds. Winds influence the weather of a place. Winds influence the weather of a place. So wind depends on the weather of a place. Depending on the place of their origin, the winds coming from cold region decrease the temperature of the region. The winds coming from the cold region or the winds coming from the Himalayan region decreases the temperature of the region. The winds which are coming from the cold regions, that winds decreases the temperature. Whereas the winds coming from the hot region decreases the temperature of the region. The winds coming from cold regions decrease the temperature of the region, whereas the winds coming from the hot regions increase the temperature of the region. So winds depends on the weather of a place. The winds which are coming from the cold regions decrease the temperature, whereas the winds coming from the hot regions increase the temperature. The winds coming from the sea make the region humid. The winds which are coming from the sea level make the region humid. Humid means it is a quantity of a water vapor level in the atmosphere. Direction of the winds. So humid. Humid means it is a quantity of a water vapor levels in the atmosphere. Quantity of water vapors in the atmosphere. Quantity of water vapors in the atmosphere, that we call humid. So the winds coming from the sea make the region humid. The winds which are coming from the sea level, that winds make the region of that winds make the place humid. And the fifth one is the fifth one point is the humidity. Humidity means the quantity of water vapors in the atmosphere. The amount of moisture of water vapor in the air is called humidity. Humidity means the amount or quantity of water vapors in the atmosphere or in the air is called humidity. The amount of moisture or water vapor in the air is called humidity. It affects the climate of a place. So humidity affects the climate of a place. Winds blowing from the sea have a lot of moisture in them. Winds which are blowing from the sea have a lot of moisture. Moisture means water vapors. The winds which are blowing from the sea have a lot of water vapors. This is why places near the sea such as Mumbai and Chennai are very humid. So winds that are blowing from the sea have a lot of moisture, have a lot of water vapors. Because of that, Mumbai and Chennai are very humid. The rainfall that a place receives also depends on the level of humidity in the air. The rainfall that a place receives also depends on the level of humidity in the air. So there are five factors which are determined by the climate. Okay, for the today's class it's enough. So read whatever we have discussed in today's class. And tomorrow we will continue the class.